Welcome to SVR IAS Academy. commonindia.com is our website. In General Studies Paper 3 in our mains examination, we have a syllabus called Environmental Conservation, Environmental Degradation, Environmental Pollution and Environmental Impact Assessment. For these topics, we need to collect environmental current affairs update for last 1.5 years. In this video lecture, we are going to explain one important environmental current affairs topic. Aeroplanes are affecting the ozone layer and monsoon. How? You might be knowing some basic points about ozone layer. The chemical formula for ozone is O3. Ozone is formed when ultraviolet radiation from the sun falls upon the oxygen. The oxygen atom is split into two oxygen. So the oxygen O2 molecule is divided into two oxygen atoms, as you can see in the image. So when oxygen molecule joins with the oxygen atom, ozone is formed. Ozone is mainly formed in the lower layer of the stratosphere. As you may know, in the atmosphere, there are four layers are there: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, and ionosphere. So, the ozone layer is located in the lower part of the stratosphere. The main role played by the ozone is to absorb the harmful ultraviolet radiation that is coming from the sun. If there is no ozone layer in the atmosphere, means life is not possible on the earth. So, ozone layer is vital for the survival of the life on the earth. Recently, scientists and climate researchers from the different institutions in the world came together and done an analysis. What is the impact of the aeroplanes on the environment? Aeroplanes, when flying, ejects significant amount of black carbon. Black carbon is a pollutant. Black carbon warms the earth. It means the black carbon absorbs the sunlight and heat the atmosphere. So the heat in the atmosphere increases because of the black carbon. So it is one of the greenhouse gas. When black carbon gets deposited over the snow and ice, it reduces the black albedo of the snow. Albedo means the reflective ability. So when sunlight falls upon the pure ice, it gets reflected back. So ice absorbs very less amount of heat. When black carbon gets deposited over the glaciers and ice sheets, as already we discussed, black carbon absorbs the heat. So because of the heat from the black carbon, ice and glaciers start melting faster. But one important exam point is that black carbon stays in the atmosphere only for days to weeks, whereas carbon dioxide has the atmospheric lifetime of more than 100 years. This is one of the advantage. If black carbon has atmospheric life of more than 100 years like carbon dioxide, means it will have a disastrous consequences on the climate of earth. So it has only days to weeks of atmospheric life. Because of the black carbon that is released from the aeroplanes, they cause the breathing problems and changes the monsoon pattern and also leads to the faster melting of the glaciers and also depletes the ozone layer. These are all the various impacts of the black carbon on the environment. Earlier, scientists thought that black carbon will not travel upward beyond 4 kilometers. But recently, the group of scientists found evidence that black carbon may also reach up to 18 kilometers into the stratosphere. As already we discussed, ozone layer is located on the lower portion of the stratosphere, where black carbon interacts with the ozone and which leads to ozone depletion. This is for the first time scientists have proven that black carbon that is coming from the aircraft can reach the stratosphere and may affect the ozone layer. This is for the first time scientists have proved this. One important point about stratosphere is that it is the stable region of the atmosphere. It is the stable region of atmosphere. That is the reason why we are flying the aircraft in the lower portion of the stratosphere. When black carbon particles deposits, they absorb the heat and they warm the surrounding air. When air gets warmer, it becomes lighter. So lighter air will tend to move upwards. This process is called as self-lift. So self-lift means when black carbon gets deposited, they absorb the heat and the surrounding air gets warmer, and warmer air tends to rise upwards. This kind of process is called as self-lift. So in this video lecture, we learned what is ozone, where it is found, and what is black carbon, what are the various consequences of black carbon on the environment, especially it leads to depletion of the ozone layer, increases the melting rate of glaciers, and changes the monsoon pattern and other effects. So let's prepare well on this topic. It can be asked in the IAS examination. Thank you.